Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about the why shutoff pressure is required for the control valve sizing. Okay, whenever we size the control valve, so the shutoff pressure or the maximum differential pressure across the valve is very important to consider while sizing the control valve, right? So what is the significance of it, why we consider it, what is the shutoff pressure, shutoff head, that we are going to discuss in this video. Okay, so in the screen you can see that there is one pipeline. This is the one pipeline, right? And in this pipeline there is the LV165, means level control valve. LV165 is there, right? And if you consider here, so your fluid, let's suppose BFW boiler feed water is coming from the pump, right? And here this the line size of this pipe is 200, right? 200. And here is the reducer of 150, and then there is the expander of 200 into 150, right? And this is your level control valve, and this BFW is going to economizer. Can you let me in the comments box from the economizer where it will go? So this is the scenario. Okay, and let's suppose this pump, this is the centrifugal pump, means the BFW which is coming in this line, this it is coming from the pump, and let's suppose this pump is a centrifugal pump. So to understand about the shutoff pressure, let's understand about the centrifugal pump curve. So this pump curve is head versus Q, right? This is your, in Y axis there is the head, and in the X axis there is the Q, right? Now there is the three scenario. The scenario for the maximum diameter, maximum impeller diameter, weighted impeller diameter, or minimum impeller diameter, right? So now what is the shutoff pressure? To understand the shutoff pressure, let's understand the shutoff head, right? So whenever the flow rate is zero, means whenever the flow is zero, so you can simply see here, whenever the flow will zero, your head will be maximum. So in this case, for the weighted impeller diameter, if you consider the Q is zero, so your head will be maximum, right? Because after that, this curve is decreasing like that. Same for the minimum impeller diameter. If you go with the minimum impeller diameter, so this is the maximum head which you can achieve when your Q is zero, means when your pump is running dry, okay, because there is no flow. So at that time the head will be maximum. Are you getting my point, what I want to say? Okay, so if you know the head, simply we know the pressure, that is P is equal to rho gh, right? So from there, simply if the head is maximum, so pressure will be maximum. So this called the maximum or the shutoff pressure. The shutoff pressure, if you have understood about the shutoff head, now it is easy to understand the shutoff pressure. So shutoff pressure will be that pressure which will be maximum within this line, which could be maximum within this line. This will be the pressure that will be the maximum within this line. So now what is the significance of it? Its significance is that with the help of this shutoff pressure, the control valve actuator is designed. Control valve actuator is design or size, you can say. Why? Because this actuator helps the control valve to on or off. Okay, so like when the control, this with the help of this actuator, the control valve's disc or steam lift and goes down. Are you getting my point, what I want to say? So to lift this steam along with the disc, there is some force is required. Okay, so that's why to calculate this force, this shutoff pressure is required. I hope you got my point, right? So now let's suppose that if there is the shutoff pressure, the actual shutoff pressure of the pump is 40 bar. Okay, and let's suppose if there is newcomer and that gives the shutoff pressure 20 bar. Okay, in the process, in the control valve process data sheet. Now what will happen? So when this pump will achieve this pressure, right, the first of all, your It could be that this could be designed at the 40 bar, it would be not. So first of all, it could be damaged, your line could be damaged. And the second thing is that in that case, so now let's suppose that your wall is closed. So what will happen that as it will achieve more than the 20 bar, so the differential pressure will be created here, because in that case, in the downstream, the pressure is zero because it is closed, and till here, there will be the maximum pressure. So delta P will be maximum, delta P will be maximum, and your actuator is not designed for the more than 20 bar. So what will happen that it will not open, because your actuator will not able to lift the disc, right? And same when it will be open, let's suppose your wall is open and the pressure increases more than 20 bar, okay? So please let me in the comments box what will happen in that case, whether your wall will be closed or not. So that is the question for you all. Please let me in the comments box, right? So I hope you got the point that what is the significance of the shutoff pressure. If we will not consider the sufficient or the accurate shutoff pressure, so your wall actuator will not be designed, okay? So in the case of the level control wall, the actuator plays a very, very important role, right? So I hope you understood about the shutoff pressure. I hope you understood about the concept which I told you here in the video. So if you learned something new from this video, please like this video, share with your friends, as well as watch our other videos about the centrifugal pump, industrial videos, or the instrumentation videos, which is already there is in the playlist. So please watch that video. So that's all for the today's video. Thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning.